Don't forget to click the subscribe button and click the bell icon.
Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm your host Kavita. Today we are going to learn how to make
special and unique aloo cheese paratha.
This is basically an Indian flat bread made of wheat flour and stuffed with boiled potatoes and spices to it. To give a unique twist, I have added cheese to it. It will give a cheesy flavor to the potatoes.
So I hope you are ready with the ingredients. Let's start. First, I am taking 2 cups of wheat flour in a bowl and add 1/2 spoon of salt to it and knead the dough. The water should be normal temperature. So knead the dough by adding water, cup by cup or 1/2 cup by cup, so that there should not be more water in the dough. So this is the consistency of the dough we will be using for making aloo and cheese paratha. Knead the dough for 5 minutes more, so that if there is any dry wheat flour left, it will be kneaded properly. Now I am adding 1/2 spoon of oil to it and knead it again for a minute or so. Now cover it with the transparent film and we will make the stuffing ready and then we will use the dough. So it will take around 15 minutes to make the stuffing. So let it set, let the dough set for some time. You can either cover it with a plate if you don't have this film, transparent film. So let's start with the stuffing. Take a pan and add 2 spoons of oil to it. This is carom seeds. Add carom seeds to it. Now add 1 1/2 spoons of fennel seeds or sauf. I have also used 1 spoon of carom seeds. Now add garlic grated and red and green chilies. If you don't have red and green chilies, you can use red chili powder, but later. So let all these 4 ingredients saute for a minute or so till the flavor, raw flavor of the garlic will not be there. So roast it for a medium flame for a minute or two. boiled potatoes. I have taken around 12 potatoes, 12 to 14 potatoes. So boil them for 20 to 25 minutes in a cooker, and then add that boiled potatoes to this mixture. Switch off the flame now. Mash them with your hand and then put that in this spices. Mix properly all these ingredients. Take a small spoon, and now I'm adding 1 spoon of salt to it, and then take a spoon and mash all these potatoes and mixture, and let all these ingredients mix properly with this spoon. Now our stuffing is ready. Now we take out the dough and we make around 3 inches of roll from that dough. Take the dough from in your hand, and then 3 inches of dough we are taking from that dough, big dough. Make some balls. Take the dry wheat and then roll it with a rolling pin. Now see, I have rolled it to the half of the size of the paratha. I have made some balls with that potato mixture. Press it in the dough, flattened dough. Now this is cheese I am using mozzarella cheese. So take some other part of the potato mixture also, put on the above the cheese mixture. Now take the dough from all the sides and make it as a dough. As you can see in the video, roll it with your hands so that there is no gap in between, and the potato mixtures will not come out of the dough. Now with the dry wheat flour and with the rolling pin, roll it with the soft hands. Don't use hard hands, or don't use so much pressure so that the potato mixture will come out of the dough. Roll it in the desired shape in a circle. Now we will roast it in a pan by applying ghee on both the sides. Thank you. So your cheesy potato paratha or aloo cheese paratha is ready to eat. This can be eaten as it is also, or it can be also eaten with curd. Curd is a very good option when you are eating this kind of parathas, like aloo paratha, gobi paratha and other parathas. This will help you to cool down your stomach if you are having stomach problems. So I hope you like this video of making of aloo and cheese paratha. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Journey of Kitchen. You can also give the comments below. And if you have tried this aloo paratha and you have got very good comments, so please share in the comments box by sharing your aloo paratha picture also. So see you next time. Namaste.